Bovine spongiform encephalopathy, or BSE, was first diagnosed in 1986. Despite extensive research, there is no reliable laboratory test for diagnosing this disease in live cattle. It is therefore imperative that all people working with cattle are familiar with the symptoms of BSE and the procedures involved in a physical examination of suspected cases to prevent the slaughter of cattle with BSE for human consumption. Over 95% of cattle with BSE have abnormalities in behaviour, locomotion, and sensitivity to external stimuli. This video shows these abnormalities and demonstrates how behaviour, sensitivity, and locomotion are evaluated in cattle with BSE. We will begin with behaviour. First, let's look at a healthy cow. The cow is standing quietly in the examination room and is calmly observing the unfamiliar surroundings. Cattle with BSE are in decreasing frequency panicky, anxious, nervous, and defensive. In addition, salivation, licking of the muzzle, and increased awareness are frequently seen. Cows with BSE often kick during milking or other daily chores. However, spontaneous aggression rarely occurs. The following sequences show these behavioural abnormalities in cows with BSE. Constant muscle fasciculations, jerking, and an anxious, bug-eyed appearance are seen in this cow. There are muscle fasciculations involving the entire body. The record number of the animal is shown in the lower right-hand corner of the picture. Panic-stricken behavior is a lead symptom in this cow. She flinches for no apparent reason. The cow is very alert and moves her ears frequently. This cow is also panicky. She flinches suddenly and is very wary. Sometimes she has muscle fasciculations. She keeps staring at the ceiling. In this cow, muscle fasciculations are an important symptom of BSE. Frequent licking of the muzzle is also a significant sign of BSE. However, we have rarely observed yawning as a behavioural abnormality in affected cattle. As well as licking her muzzle, this cow frequently grinds her teeth, which is often seen in BSE. This cow with BSE suddenly flinches for no apparent reason, as we will see. She unexpectedly kicks out while being led over the in-ground scale. Another cow exhibits the same behavioural abnormality while in a paddock. Sometimes kicking is accompanied by repeated jerking of a limb. This symptom can be seen even with severe hind limb ataxia. Abnormal sensitivity is another cardinal symptom of BSE. Cattle with BSE are, in decreasing frequency, hypersensitive to touch, sound, and light. The examiner first tests sensitivity to tactile stimuli by touching the animal with his or her hand. The main areas evaluated are the shoulder, neck and head. A healthy cow stands quietly during this procedure. The intensity of the stimulus is increased by using a pen. Healthy cattle have little or no reaction. Cattle with BSE are commonly hypersensitive in the neck and head regions. The reaction of cattle with BSE to touch may vary. This cow with BSE is not overly sensitive to the touch of a hand. However, by stimulating the neck region of the same cow with a pen, muscle fasciculations, salivation, head tossing and nervous ear movements occur. The cow appears anxious. This cow is very sensitive to both types of tactile stimulation in the chest area. She wrinkles her nose, salivates and tosses her head. This cow has a very mild reaction to the touch of a hand. But stimulation using a pen causes head shaking, salivation, snorting, and muscle fasciculations. This Simmental cow is hypersensitive to touch in the head and neck regions. Her reaction becomes more pronounced when a pen is used. This cow with BSE has a mild defensive reaction to touch. However, an increase in the intensity of the stimulation produces a very different reaction. The cow shakes her head violently, hits the examiner with her head, salivates, and wrinkles her nose. This brown Swiss cow demonstrates once again how varied the reaction to touching with either a hand or a pen can be. She is tense when the examiner's hand touches her. A more intensive stimulus on her neck results in a marked reaction. She shakes her head vigorously and pulls back on the rope. The sensitivity in the hind limbs is tested with a broom. The so-called broom test is repeated several times. This healthy cow does not react to the broom touching her fetlocks, and she continues to chew her cud. A reproducible reaction is considered a positive sign, as shown by this cow with BSE. Hypersensitivity often manifests as vigorous kicking. The state of excitement of this cow increases markedly. She is restless, bellows, and extends her tongue. This cow with BSE has a marked reaction when the broom is extended towards her. She presses forward and then tries to jump over the bar, but is left straddling it. Hypersensitivity to sound may occur, for example, when a door is slammed shut or with hand clapping. We use a metal container and a rubber hammer to test an animal's reaction to sound. The test is repeated a number of times. Sometimes healthy cows are frightened when they hear the sound for the first time, but they quickly become accustomed to it. This healthy cow has very little reaction to the sound. This cow with BSE is frightened every time the sound is made, and she pulls back on her tether. This test is considered positive because the reaction is reproducible. This animal also pulls back on her rope and flinches each time the sound is made. This cow displays a marked hypersensitivity to sound. She flinches suddenly and pulls back on her tether. After being severely frightened, this cow tries to get away and is extremely agitated. Other symptoms, such as salivation and wrinkling of the nose, may also occur. Sensitivity to light may be tested using a bright light source or a camera flash. First, we will observe the reaction to a bright light source. The room is darkened. The light is aimed toward the animal and then turned on. The animal's reaction is evaluated. This procedure is repeated several times. This healthy cow looks at the light and remains undisturbed. This cow has an abnormal reaction to the light. Every time the light is turned on, she flinches. This cow also flinches suddenly each time the light is turned on. In addition, there are constant muscle fasciculations in the shoulder region. This cow reacts to the light by attempting to get away. This thin brown Swiss cow is extremely frightened, salivates, and pulls back on her rope. When a dark room is not available, a camera flash can be used to evaluate hypersensitivity to light. As with the test using a bright light source, this test is repeated several times. This healthy cow does not react to the camera flash. Hypersensitivity to light usually manifests as sudden flinching or jerking. In addition to sudden jerking, affected animals may have other symptoms, such as salivation, which is seen here. This cow flinches repeatedly. She also has constant muscle fasciculations in the shoulder region. We see that this cow is markedly sensitive to the camera flash. She flinches violently and pulls back on her tether. Abnormalities of locomotion manifest as ataxia, stiff gait, and hypermetria, and sometimes affected animals have a pacing gait. First, the animal is assessed as it walks over a small obstacle or an irregularity in the pavement, such as a crevice or painted line. Abnormal reactions may also be seen as an animal passes through a narrow opening, such as a doorway. In addition, the gait is evaluated as the animal is led and while it is loose in a paddock. First, we will evaluate healthy cows. The cow walks over the manure gutter without hesitating and without any great effort. She is not frightened as she walks through the barn doorway. This healthy cow leaves the examination room quietly and steps over the sewer grate and wooden pole with an even gait. She steps over the crevice of the in-ground scale with the same even gait. In the following sequences, we will see cows with BSE, which frequently have difficulty navigating these small obstacles. This cow with BSE stops in front of the pole, hesitates, jumps over it, and then calmly walks on. Another cow with BSE hesitates while exiting the examination room and then makes a small jump. She steps over the obstacle with a hypermetric gait. This animal exhibits similar abnormalities in locomotion. This next cow with BSE leaps over the sewer grate and the small obstacle. Another animal hesitates in front of the sewer grate, jumps, and then abruptly stops. This next cow refuses to step over the narrow sewer grate. After some encouragement, she tries to jump over the sewer grate, but falls down. Even small irregularities on the ground, such as the crevice of the in-ground scale, are enough to stop this animal with BSE before it carefully steps over it. The same crevice causes this cow to have an abnormal gait. Another cow steps over a very small obstacle with an excessively large jump. For example, here, over the sewer grate and wooden pole. She also jumps over the crevice of the in-ground scale. Let's evaluate gait. This healthy cow has a normal, even gait as she walks along the pavement. Even in the snow, this cow's gait is normal as she walks across the field. Obviously, she would also do this without snow. Cattle with BSE commonly have gait abnormalities, but they can be subtle during early stages of the disease. high stepping in the hind limbs, as well as interference of the hind limbs, are seen in this animal with BSE. This cow with BSE has marked hind limb ataxia. She also crosses her hind limbs while walking. These symptoms are more pronounced when the cow is free in the paddock. She also staggers. This animal also has marked hind limb ataxia while loose in the paddock. In addition to hind limb ataxia, this cow is pacing. The position of her ears gives her a remarkably alert expression. After falling, she has difficulty standing up and then starts to pace again. This cow moves her ears and tail anxiously. She also has hind limb ataxia and marked hypermetria, involving the left hind limb. This Holstein Friesian cow has hypermetria involving both hind limbs. She starts to collapse on her hind limbs, but is able to correct her stance. This red Holstein cow has severe hypermetria involving the left hind limb. She has difficulty maintaining her balance in the hind end, staggers, and falls against the fence. Ataxia can be generalized, which we see in this cow with a stiff gait. This cow with BSE also has a very stiff gait, which may be confused with other diseases, such as laminitis. Sometimes abnormal locomotion manifests as pacing in cows with BSE. Normally, the limbs move forward in diagonal pairs, as we see in this healthy cow, shown in slow motion for better understanding. The left forelimb and right hind limb move forward together, followed by the right forelimb and left hind limb. In the classical pace, both limbs on the same side move forward together, as we see in this cow with BSE. The left fore and hind limbs move forward and strike the ground simultaneously. In the same cow, now in real time, pacing is clearly noticeable. The limbs on the same side move forward simultaneously. Pacing may also be seen when affected cows, such as the one here, are loose in a paddock. Sometimes pacing is not as pronounced, or may be intermittent, as seen in this cow with BSE. Disturbances of locomotion may be so severe that affected animals fall down and have great difficulty getting up again. This cow has fallen while crossing the manure gutter, and only after some encouragement is she able to rise with difficulty. She then proceeds with a stiff gait. Another cow with BSE falls down while being led and cannot stand up again. In the terminal stages of BSE, animals are unable to rise and remain recumbent. It is therefore imperative to consider the possibility of BSE and to examine downer cattle for this disease. This cow with BSE is unable to stand up and appears anxious. She looks in the direction of the examiner and opens her mouth. She barely reacts to the touch of a hand, but, as we will see in a moment, is extremely sensitive to stimulation with a pen. The sound causes her to become very nervous. She looks anxious and attempts to rise unsuccessfully. This 7-year-old brown Swiss cow was referred to our clinic because of inability to stand. She is 8 months pregnant and has been down for 1 day. After being assisted to a standing position with the cow lift, she exhibits very abnormal behavior. She wrinkles her nose, snorts, and licks her muzzle excessively. The following day, she is down again. Stimulation with a pen causes her to shake her head. A clinical diagnosis of BSE was confirmed at post-mortem examination. This cow is also in the terminal stages of BSE and is in lateral recumbency with opisthotonus and rigid extension of the limbs. She is 9 months pregnant. Stimulation with a pen elicits a reaction mainly in the head and neck regions. She groans and makes paddling movements. The cow flinches each time the sound is made. The examination for BSE in cattle that are not handled often will be demonstrated in a cow-calf operation. First, let's evaluate the gait and behavior of this healthy Angus cow with her calf. The cow is restrained in a chute with her calf behind her. Sensitivity is assessed as demonstrated previously. The cow tolerates being touched with the examiner's hand, and a pen has no defensive reaction, although she is not used to being touched by people. Likewise, she does not react to the broom. She listens to the noise, but does not react abnormally. The camera flash does not frighten her. This example has demonstrated that cattle that are not accustomed to being handled by people, such as those from cow-calf or large dairy operations, can be examined for BSE. A brief examination for BSE can also be carried out in cattle during the live animal inspection at the slaughterhouse. In Switzerland, a so-called BSE check is performed in all slaughter cattle that are more than 30 months of age. A veterinarian at the slaughterhouse first checks the ear tag and then evaluates sensitivity to stimulation with a pen in the neck and head regions. The animal's reaction to a camera flash, as well as its sensitivity in the hind limb area, are also assessed. This cow tolerates the examiner's hand and touching with a pen. She also does not react to the camera flash and broom test. This cow also shows no reaction. This cow appears nervous, and she is salivating. BSE is a possible rule out. However, she does not react to the pen, the camera flash, and the broom. Her gait was normal, and the post-mortem examination was negative for BSE. After evaluating behaviour and sensitivity, the slaughterhouse veterinarian assesses the gait of the animals as they leave the truck. These simple examination procedures can be used to identify suspicious cases before slaughter, so that they can be observed and examined more thoroughly. The BSE check at the slaughterhouse is therefore an important procedure for public health and food safety. We will conclude by performing the complete examination in a cow with BSE. Severin is an 8-year-old cow. She is 5 months pregnant and originates from a cow-calf operation in the lower alpine region. For the past 2 months, she has been nervous and once was a downer cow. For the past week, she has had difficulty rising and has been afraid of unfamiliar people. The owner has noticed weight loss, although the cow's appetite has been good. BSE was suspected and the cow was referred to our clinic. Let's start with the examination. Her behavior is unremarkable at first. An inadvertent noise causes her to toss her head and snort. Touching her with a hand results in head tossing and nervous ear movements. This reaction becomes more pronounced when a pen is used. She shakes her head, wrinkles her nose, and salivates. She is not hypersensitive when touched with a broom. The cow flinches when a sound is made and pulls back on her rope without becoming accustomed to the noise. She flinches each time the light is turned on. Her reaction is the same when the camera flash is used. Finally, let's evaluate this cow's gait. The cow is ataxic when stepping over the obstacle. No abnormalities in locomotion are seen when the cow is led. However, when loose in a paddock, marked hypermetria of the left hind limb is seen. Based on abnormalities of behavior, sensitivity and gait, a clinical diagnosis of BSE was made, which was confirmed at post-mortem examination. In conclusion, approximately 90% of cattle with BSE have abnormalities in behavior, sensitivity and locomotion. Ideally, a tentative diagnosis of BSE would be made by the herdsperson, who is most familiar with the cattle. However, The symptoms are sometimes overlooked or incorrectly interpreted. It would therefore be desirable that cattle dealers and truckers be familiar with the symptoms of BSE. Kurt Oertle picked up this cow and brought her to the clinic because she had difficulty rising. He made the following observations.
Die Kuh hat Mühe gehabt mit Aufstehen und beim Auslaufen hat sie geschwankt. Da habe ich gedacht, sie könnte noch BSE haben.
After examination, the cow was euthanized. The post-mortem diagnosis was inflammation of the brain and spinal cord, or meningoencephalitis.